Hello, I'm Rory Sutherland. I'm the Vice-Chairman of the Ogilvy Group in the UK. Technology combined with behavioural economics can achieve wonderfully well. There's a little one involving those road signs which flash by the side of the road, and as you drive past, they flash up your speed, and some of the more sophisticated ones actually show a smiley face if you're going within the speed limit, or they show a frown if you're going too fast. But that's quite interesting in itself. What's really interesting, though, is that these things cost about 5 to 10% of the annual running cost of a speed camera, and yet they prevent twice as many accidents. Now, when you think about that from a conventional economics point of view, the idea that gentle, nudging, timely persuasion should be more effective at changing human behaviour for the better than the threat of punishment, the threat of a fine, the threat of 3 penalty points on your licence, is completely bizarre. It's absolutely unexpected. But it's a very, very interesting revelation about human behaviour. And then you realise suddenly the number of times that government, and government, of course, is dominated by legislators, lawyers, people who actually have spent their entire working lives dreaming up legislation. Government tends to look to solve problems by compulsion, even by the threat of punishment, before it's even tried intelligent, gentle, or timely persuasion. And that bias seems to me completely wrong. Whereas punishment may be necessary, it may be absolutely necessary to occasionally reserve a threat or to have a stick as well as carrots, it seems to me completely wrong that people should actually resort to the stick before they've even tried the carrot. And yet so much governmental policy seems to actually operate that way around. That just seems completely wrong. So that seems to be very, very interesting. What makes this all the more interesting is, of course, that's a technological solution to warning people they're going too fast. The number of nudges you can use by perhaps employing the mobile phone, the text message, little bits of contextual information to provide people with helpful information when they've drunk too much, when they're driving too fast, when they're doing something they really shouldn't be, seems to me to have extraordinary potential for actually improving social outcomes without the usual heavy-handed approach that we've had so far. And that seems to be something that technology combined with behavioural economics can achieve wonderfully well.